Joe G. Hey, that's my name. Hey, my husky gets very nervous and shakes and will step when he is corrected for staring at a dog. Mine is reactive. He will also shake and step when I use a verbal cue.
Step?
Only when it...
What's that word you're using?
Step.
Step? What do you mean step?
I don't know what that...
Is that a dance move?
Step.
Shake and step. And back and right and left. Swing your hips.
Like to avoid the correction maybe? Like...
So if you've got a nervous dog, you're probably experiencing the messy middle right now where your dog is either anticipating a correction, which is possible. So what I want you to do is, bottom line is, as long as your dog's not, is reacting, you're winning. Next. Going live. Now we're live. Hey everybody, how are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. How's everybody doing? Let's adjust this camera to... Will you move over?
I can't. Your big chair's in the way.
There you go. Right there. There we go. Hey everybody, how are you? Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. All right, what would Jeff do? 90-minute show. It's Q&A, the answer. Questions come fast. The answers are even faster. Theoretically, everybody needs like a much bigger answer. But what you're going to notice is we always talk about punishment on this show. Remember, punishment, there's no yelling, there's no screaming, you're not mad, you're not upset, you're not holding a grudge. I'm not upset with you. It's just like you can't do that for the dog. This concept that dogs will always make the right choice is wrong. That they always want to please you is not necessarily correct. That's this show. Then we have something called Jeff Gellman Seminars. Go to jeffgellmanseminars.com. We're doing 28 seminars in 7 countries in 2020. Next one coming up is in Pearson, Florida. Go there. That's also a troubleshooting seminar as well. That one also is based on how to stop unwanted behaviors. In order to stop an unwanted behavior, you've got to learn how to apply a proper punisher. Punishment is not a bad word, just like reward is not a bad word. In fact, reward can actually F things up more than punishment can. Now, the training center, which we're sitting in, that's different now. That's probably 95% reward, 5% punishment. Why? Punishment takes seconds. Reward, tons of it. Tons of it. Massive, massive repetition. So what's going to happen is Joelle asks the questions. I do the answers. Every once in a while, I go on a rant. So we try to answer as many questions as we can in the 90 minutes. But it is a 90-minute show. I mean, it's a free show, so we're doing the best we can. If you want your question to go to the top of the queue, you do something called Top Chat. There's a dollar sign there. But you do not have to pay to play. You don't. We'll get through as many questions as possible. And let's go right, Joelle. Let's jump right in. Is the camera height okay? Are you okay with that?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Let's go.
Murph said, good evening, y'all. Let's get it.
All right, Murph.
She also said, my ACD is resource guarding toys when at the park. I corrected with e-collar on a high level. Doesn't stop. Should I try using the bonker as well? Mm. Other ideas?
Why? What kind of toys at the park? And why are there toys at the park? And are you at a dog park? What kind of toys? Are we talking about a ball? What are we talking about next?
Eric, good evening. How do you guys go about practice reps of the out command? I understand teaching it, but not sure how to do reps.
You can only do so many reps because then the dog stops doing it. What you can do is what the most things you can practice out
there was more
is
to that. You totally cut me off.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Like a whole
oh, I'm sorry. I thought, go ahead.
No. Jeez.
Just don't hit me anymore. I'm still recovering.
Arms are
there you go.
Safely crossed.
Thank you.
I saw you had a video of a dog at the center happily moving away. When I do it, the dogs become a little stressed. Avoidance,
yep.
No big deal, but then they anticipate the outcoming.
Right.
I practice with food in their bowl,
yep.
So sometimes they get to the point that they don't go to the bowl.
Yep, absolutely. That happens with us.
I have a resource guarding husky coming in for board and train. So excited to teach him the out command. Thank you for everything.
Excellent. So you can out from a ball, out from a tug, out from a food bowl or a resource, and out from get out of here. But... if a dog happily moves away from out, that's because it's probably more of a high energy, happier dog. We get a lot of nervous, fearful, shutdown dogs here. They don't look thrilled. They don't look thrilled. And we show that work too. Bottom line is out means physically and mentally move away from something. Next.
It helps if you just do the reps though with people because they're always going to want to go up to the human.
Historically.
And then you just out them off people.
Yes.
And it transfers.
Next.
Mako Cheese says, hey.
Hey.
Gretchen, Can't stay because it's Wednesday, but wanted to drop in and say hi. Your live watcher rate has been up by 50 people or so since New Year's.
Wow.
What are you going to do when questions start coming in faster than you can answer
them live? Which is happening today.
You might get deplatformed before that happens.
No, so thanks a lot for the...
Thanks, Gretchen.
Thanks, Gretchen, for the sending out the positive vibes, okay? See you later. Bye.
Barista boy. Hey, guys. Just going to absorb some great info tonight. Thanks again.
Awesome. Absorb all you can. And I was my own barista tonight with my What Would Jeff Do? Remember, you can join our mug club if you go to sallycaninetraining.com/shop. You get a white cup with black lettering, a couple of stickers, all for $20, shipping included. Next.
With my coffee.
I asked you if you wanted to make... I fucking asked you if you wanted a coffee.
I just like busting your...
You want me to make your coffee? Make your coffee?
No.
Okay.
Jordy, I'll drink my lemon water.
Okay.
Hey guys, I just got an e-collar for my year and a half GSD. What tips do you have to start off strong and get a good understanding of how it's used and how to start my dog's training?
All right, number one, it comes with an owner's manual. Read the owner's manual. Also, think about getting thick fur contact points. It's an aftermarket accessory. You can go to ecollar.com for that. For your GSD, contact is everything. Make sure you have the proper contact. Start with a good command would be the place command. Also, understand the concept of pressure on, pressure off. We don't recommend using vibrate. Just understand how to use it. Understand how to use it, but read the owner's manual next, and then watch a ton of our free videos.
Michelle Anderson, good evening, Jeff, Joelle, Melissa, and fellow fans.
Hey, Michelle, thank you so much for being a part of this. Next,
Jamie. Hey, J&J. Hope y'all had a good day.
Damn right, good fucking day. We made
always a good day.
Two videos today.
Three.
Well,
we made three videos.
Yeah, so we're adding to our do-it-yourself video 2020. We're actually calling it the 2020 do-it-yourself how-to video things. We did...
How-to video things.
No, we did two. How to fit... Oh, no, we did a new intro.
Intro.
We made a brand new intro to our YouTube channel and our website. And then we also did a how to fit a prong collar and how to start introducing the prong collar. Simple processes for my Canadians Loser processes. And those will be up very, very soon. Awesome. Good job filming, by the way.
Thanks.
Good job. You know, I'm so comfortable when I don't want anybody else to be holding the camera when we're doing these how-tos.
I started laughing my ass off though in the middle of that one. You make like these dumb corny jokes, like dad jokes, like right in the middle of it, and I'm like, I just couldn't hold it in. I just couldn't. It was funny. You said something stupid. I don't know. I might make like a blooper reel.
You should make a blooper reel. Next.
Jamie, hey J&J. Oh, I already read that. Melissa said, good evening, Jeff, Joel, and everyone in
the chat. Hey, Melissa, love you.
Melissa, Mako Cheese, I didn't think I'd ever like Mondays and Wednesdays until I found this.
Mondays? Guys, Mondays, I love. I love Mondays. Next.
Murph, Joel, I love your hat. Thank you.
Yeah, you got cool hats.
Love my hat.
Where's that white with the whitish one that I saw laying around?
Right there.
It's right there. There it is.
That's usually my go-to.
Yeah, I like that one a lot.
Levi, any tips for working a long line? Mine is 15 feet, but I don't always allow all of it out.
I don't know. What are you trying to do? Recall? You know, I would get a longer long line too. Long lines can be, it's got its pros and its cons. They can be a pain in the ass because they get twisted up in the dog's legs or twisted up in something, but also you can save your dog's life with it. So, I mean, long lines are great for recall. Next.
Levi said, any tips for working, Jesus Christ, for existence training? Do you find if you make progress, have an accident you couldn't avoid, does the dog regress?
No, it's a learning experience. Next.
Adventure McLoy, hey J&J, I just wanted to say thanks again for the advice. The GSD now goes outside with little to no noise, so thankful I was able to watch New Year's Live. You guys are awesome.
Awesome. But just remember, making a mistake is a learning opportunity for both the human and the dog. And I'm not just talking about dog training. Making mistakes is how we learn. Please remember that. I have built this company on making mistakes. That's why I can have a business consulting company. Like, the advice that I might give you might save you $50,000. The advice I might give you might make you $50,000 extra. So how did I know all this stuff? I've already made the mistakes. So everyone should find a mentor. Next.
Mentor. Is that how you say mentor?
Mentor. Speaking of Akron, there's another city in Ohio called Mentor.
Everyone is ripping on me on freaking IG for that today.
That was on Angelo's
Thanks
post.
A lot.
That was Angelo.
Thanks a lot.
I threw an Angelo, a great, by the way, that picture, by the way, Kudos to Joelle for taking the photos.
I take a nice picture.
Hold on here. I just said it.
Rip me apart.
I just fucking just said kudos to you for taking probably the most favorite picture I've seen since I've been doing social media. That was it.
You're welcome.
That was a wonderful photo. I think I want to get that photo. What are you gonna do? I think you can send that photo over to Walgreens and they'll print it out for you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think I want that. It's a beautiful photo. Next.
Levi, both my dogs have some dog reactivity. Good with people. We're at the vet, training existence. Guy with a dog and his phone left his dog rush us. And I tried as fast as I could to back out. But by then, my 2-year-old male snapped.
Yep.
And the 1-year-old female followed. We backed away. Space and time were tight, so I missed the correction.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I mean, if dogs... Okay, bottom line is this. I got 3 dogs that I work. So my 2 German Shepherds and my Malinois. If an off-leash dog runs on my dogs, they're not going to just stand there. And if anybody thinks that's a training failure, fuck them. I'm sorry. I'm not going to let my dogs be targets. I got no problem at all with my dog snapping and an off-leash dog rushing them. I don't. If someone's going to get bit, I don't want it to be my dogs. Next.
John, evening guys. Hope hump day was a great day.
It was. Hey, Melissa, can you find out why Dark Warrior's stuff keeps getting hidden and fix that? Because he's acceptable. I don't know why. Because
it has the word shit in it?
Can we?
That seems weird. I feel like people swear all the time.
Who's Melissa, who's blocking fucking shit? Is that us or YouTube? Thanks. Next.
Jamie, any recommendations for prongs that don't leave ugly gray stains? Have you ever had this problem with any of your dogs?
On a white fur dog, on a cheaper prong, get the Kerrigan ones or stainless steel next.
Levi, how can I improve this? And do you find with housemates, if one reacts, the other follows? My female is hardly like that unless she sees the male.
Yes, that happens often. Next. How can you improve it? Just role play it. But remember, there's always the what ifs. Next.
Lexi, I've taken your advice on the 180 and it works. She follows me perfectly when I turn, no matter what speed and whenever, but she still tries to walk ahead of me when going straight. Alone, she's great.
I'm sorry.
But with my friend and her dog, she tenses up, speeds up all the time.
Yep.
Turns if I turn, cannot do the 180, jumps back into the side if I turn in.
Yep.
Speeds up again on straight. Advice?
Do variable speed walking, play leapfrog with your friend, and we will make a spatial pressure video. Next.
Levi said, I think we do all the right work. Bosu sits, two-person recall, public access, downstays, and structured play, and more. How can we build on this, and how does it help reactivity?
Also, you know what? What was your videotape what I did with that German Shepherd today? So
showing corrections, though.
We're going to have to, though, because it was so valuable. I put that dog in such a good state of mind before we even made it out the fucking door. So what I want you to do is number one, you know, being consistent with holding your dog accountable for simple tasks, simple things, become more valuable to your dog, things like that. Next.
Charisse said, hey, Jeff and Joelle, it's been forever since I've caught you. I miss y'all.
Yep, now 3 days a week. I can't get into, the problem is I can't get into all these like extensive answers because I want to get through all these things. Next.
Joe G. Hey, that's my name. Hey, my husky gets very nervous and shakes and will step when he is corrected for staring at a dog. Mine is reactive. He will also shake and step when I use a verbal cue.
Step?
Only when it...
What's that word you're using?
Step.
Step? What do you mean step?
I don't know what that...
Is that a dance move?
Step.
Shake and step. And back and right and left. Swing your hips.
Like to avoid the correction maybe? Like...
If you've got a nervous dog, you're probably experiencing the messy middle right now where your dog is either anticipating a correction, which is possible. So what I want you to do is, bottom line is, as long as your dog's not is reacting, you're winning. Next.
Eldo. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. Been a while. Mini educators on the way from the U.S.
Awesome.
By the way, I'm fostering a female bully right now. She's very reactive to cat or mouse. What should I do to train without prong or e-collar?
You can use a bot. First of all, you don't need a. People have been training their dogs for thousands of years without electronics or prong collars. All right, you just have to use. You have to figure out some form of applied punishment. You just need to find something tolerable. That's all you need to do. So you don't use a bonker. A bonker is great. A bonker is a cotton towel. Next.
Christine, one dog stands over the other while he's laying down. E-collar, out command?
You can do that. Yep, absolutely. Next.
David, hi, Jeff and Joelle. When I put the e-collar on Rocco, he seems to get nervous. I've only used sound and vibration so far, but he runs when I apply right, either. Okay. Is this normal?
First of all, not nowhere in any of my videos do I talk about using sound or vibration. Every once in a while, I talk about using tone as a marker for precursor for no, but stop using vibration. Vibration sounds better than shock, but it freaks dogs out. Stop using vibration. Also, put the collar on in the morning, take it off at night, rotate it every 3 or 4 hours, and just make it a lifestyle. Next.
Landon, who does the paintings? I like them. Paint myself, but not that detailed. Whoever did, they look cool.
That one is from Aaron Freeland. Next. Aaron Paints, I think is the name of it or something.
Aaron took your dog.
Aaron took your dog on Instagram. Next.
Gretzky, she paints those herself?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Gretzky, I have an 8-month GSD. I use a prong collar, but she still pulls. It seems for the most part I have to tire her out for her not to pull. How can I get it to where I can do it without the pre-exercise?
You don't need a pre-exercise. You need better training. So this concept that you need it. So Melissa just texted me there's a filter, but she can't remove it until after the show. There's a filter that has got swears in it, and we have to take it off because I say fucking shit. My fans say fucking shit. Yeah.
That
so
seems weird.
So, yeah. So this is the thing. This concept of you, this is such a bullshit fucking concept. You need to tire your dog out before you train it. No, you don't. Train your dog in front of you the way it is. It's like, it's no different than kids in classrooms. If you're a good fucking teacher, you can control the classroom. So what you need to do is you need to be just up your training skills, which is no fault of yours. That happens with experience or multiple dog handling or more knowledge and the application of that knowledge to get that those results. But as far as like, I can never tire my dogs out. But I can put my dogs into a rested state instantly. It's called calm on command. How do I do that? Practice long duration work. Next.
Bear. I have a 13-week-old Great Dane. He is a little stubborn. I have a print prong collar coming tomorrow. He growls and is a little spooked at people. What are the best strategies for not allowing dominance?
Okay, first of all, the dog is 13 weeks old. Scale this. He's 13 weeks old. He's going through a fear period, probably. So are people putting too much pressure on that dog like they do most puppies? Like, so are people just randomly, are you allowing random people just to walk up the dog and like get in the dog's face, speak in a high-pitched voice, put their hands out, show their teeth, go like this? That freaks out dogs. The best way to meet a dog is not to meet a dog. Or let the dog go up to the person and then tell the person to be neutral. So you want to do proper puppy raising up until 14 weeks. You don't want any negative experiences to happen if you can control it. But, you know, growling at humans, what's the context? Is the human approaching them or is this the human walking by them? Next.
Christine said, any idea what that behavior means? The dog that stands over the other dog while it's sleeping?
It's supposedly five trainers, five answers. It's dominance. But all I like to do is this. You don't want it.
It's like you're being a pain in the ass.
Yeah. It's like, what does it mean when a dog pisses on another dog? It means you have to fucking give that dog a bath.
Wes pisses on himself.
Yeah. It's like, that's what it means. Like, that's what it means. It means you have to give the dog a bath.
Yeah.
Like, what? No, it doesn't. Oh, no, it doesn't. It means that there was the third one out of the litter, and when the female was giving birth, it sprayed something on the dog, and that's why the female dog does this, da-da-da-da. It's like, no, it means you have to bathe your fucking dog. Mm-hmm. So all it means is this. Do you want it or you don't want it? I personally don't want dogs standing over sleeping dogs or sleeping babies. So what do? I fucking tell it to cut the shit. Next. Guys, I'm a pet dog trainer. I'm making it simple as possible for everybody to I don't want to say dog training for dummies because that I don't want to insult you or insult myself. I do enough self, what do they call that? Self-deprecation? Or is that like when you masturbate when you're hanging yourself?
What?
Next.
Alrighty then. Danny. Had to be serious.
No, Dark Warrior, you don't have, like, Dark Warrior right there. It's trying to hide your shit.
Yeah, so weird.
It's like.
They're like, oh, Dark Warrior, we'll put you
Dark Warrior, you're permanently on our fucking shit list, obviously, on YouTube shit list. I have to keep unhiding your comments.
What are you doing in your free time? You trolling people?
I know. Dark Warrior, what are you doing? Are you sitting in front of your fucking laptop naked? Because if you are, the fucking YouTube knows.
They know.
They know. They know. They've hacked your fucking camera and they're watching you. What are you doing? Lines of fucking coke on your goddamn screen?
First elbow of the night. Next. Danny, I have two dogs. One I put in place when the company comes over to aggressive behavior, growling, hackles. Should the other dog be in place even though she does fine?
That's up to you. Personal choice, man. It's your house, your dogs, your guests, you know, your rules. But to me, I'm just a big advocate of just like, you know what? Humans coming over my house. Hey, dogs, go mind your own business. It's good training. It's such good training for a dog to go in place and just observe the world go by. It's just good. It's just good. It's a good idea. I'm not against dogs milling about, but being someone that rehabs dogs, I'm a big advocate of like, you know what, dog, like be seen but not heard, be seen but not felt. Be seen and just like go lay down next. Because we'll do all kinds of fun. This is when company comes over. Don't worry. We played chuck it. We went swimming. We went on a hike. We went on a walk. We ran. We went and you ran next to the bike next to me. Like we're going to do activities. But when you're in the house, go lie down. Mind your business. Next.
Gretzky in my backyard house. She's very obedient. But outside, man, sometimes it's rough. But yes. She's getting better as the days go by. Thanks
yes. for everything. So hold your dog accountable in the house. I think Levi also asked, how do you become valuable to your dog? This is it. Who's your dog paying attention to? You or something else? Now, at the home, probably you. Why? Because you're the only thing that's valuable. Outside, that fucking leaf. Whoever thought a twig would be more valuable than you? I mean, if you got self-esteem issues, man, you're fucked because you've just been fucking stood up by a goddamn twig because the dog's like, there's a twig over there. Yeah, but I'm over here. The dog's like, oh, but that's a damn good looking twig. So what you need to do is go, you know what? Knock it off. So we're going to show some techniques probably tomorrow in the live, how to become more valuable to your dog. Next.
I might have to veto that one. Anyway. Murph, the park is an open field, no one area, just myself, Frank, and my boyfriend's dog. I throw a ball and leave.
Got it. So that's what happens is, unfortunately, that's one of those risks that you take when you're in an open area with dogs. Some other people can go there. A lot of people don't have recall put on their dog, so it happens. Next.
Cammy, I want to get my dog back into training, but I find that I can't handle her by myself. Too excited. I have e-collar and prong collar. What should I do?
Bonk your dog. You ready? Okay. It's an arousal issue. I own 3 high drive dogs. They are drivey, 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 drivey. But I can instantly get them to be calm. How did I do that? Through training. But I also got it by them understanding the word no and cut the shit and knock it off and all that stuff. So what you're going to do is... What you're gonna do is use your bonker, okay? Watch my videos on bonking, and you arrive somewhere, and you just go no bonk. The dog's like, that sucked. You're not taking any of the drive out of the dog. What you're doing is taking the arousal out of the dog. There is a difference. Next.
Jamie, how to transition place from go to this spot to go to this spot. Lay down and put your head down.
Nice.
My dog is really good with duration, but doesn't put his head down very often.
Okay, so that's a skill set. You have to teach that. So how do you teach the double down? You're going to do this. It's a combination of low-level remote, verbal word, leash pressure, possible luring, a little bit of each. So there's a technique to teach it, and then once you teach it, the dog should start doing it as a default. Next.
Jasmine, do you recommend the bonker over the pet convincer for hyper-focusing on other dogs? E-collar only works half the time.
Correct.
Used higher levels. Is tool issue or timing issue?
It's probably a timing issue, and it's hard to bonk in public. At least you're not supposed to, you know. Unless you want someone to make a video of you and then send you death threats and threaten your life every fucking day in the month of December. Next.
Atmospheric evening J&J. Is it okay to use spatial pressure to correct arousal?
If it works for you, but I'd rather be a little bit more invasive. But spatial pressure can be pretty invasive,
it's
though.
It's pretty invasive.
Yeah, it can be. Depends.
I got lunged at the last time.
Well, depends on how you use spatial pressure. So some people like us, we use spatial pressure very invasive, and that works actually great. Next.
Ann, I asked you a question a while ago about prepping a service dog for flying. Happy to report, despite taking a shuttle to the tarmac to get on the plane and the subway to switch terminals, which is the worst possible scenario, he did amazing.
Awesome.
Multiple people didn't realize there was a dog on the plane until we got off, including the flight attendants.
Look at you, motherfucking superstar. Proud of you. Next. Yes. Autoerotic asphyxiation.
I know.
Yes.
I kept reading that.
Yeah, that's where the kung fu guy died of that. Do you ever see the series Kung Fu?
So it's like just being choked, right?
Technically, it's being choked, but you're doing it to yourself.
Some people are into that.
And a lot of people, whenever, put it this way, whenever you see somebody hanging by a belt in their closet with their pants down, they probably died jacking off and they didn't mean to die.
Wait, so they actually hang themselves? They don't just like...
Auto, meaning they do it to themselves, right.
But like hang or like tie yourself to something, there's a difference.
In order to hang
from the ceiling or like put something behind you and kind of just put some pressure.
They historically do it from...
I'm imagining on a bedpost and you're just like sliding down a little.
Maybe a little bit. That's like the minor league.
Tolerable.
That's the minor league. When you go to the major leagues, they find you in the fucking closet next to your fucking tuxedo and your goddamn fucking clean press shirt.
Wow.
Yeah. 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 A lot of... It's a good way to die. I mean, it's not a good way to die, but it's yeah.
Anne said, do you have any tips for a DIY version of your obstacle course? It would be amazing for my service dog, but I have a 600-square-foot apartment.
So go to a playground off hours. Go to a playground off hours next.
Will, every time I see Jeff now, all I see is Han Solo. Someone get Jeff a white Henley to complete the look. I know, and he has like the brown boots.
Next.
All of it.
Next.
He needs like a big lightsaber. I don't know. He didn't use a lightsaber, did he?
Next.
He used a gun.
Okay, we're losing time.
Michelle, weather issue. Calling for 8 straight days of negative 35 Celsius. Oh my God. At negative 20, I don't allow the dogs out more than 5 minutes.
Right.
Not sure how to handle 5 dogs with that cold for 8 days. Advice?
Treadmill and 5-minute intervals.
Whew.
Yeah, get a treadmill inside.
Landon, interesting Crocs on Instagram, by the way. Purple is a royal color. Lavender is on the way.
Those were lilac Crocs.
Lilac.
They're lilac. Thank you. That's an old photo.
Not purple.
That photo is probably a minimum of 5 years, probably 8 years old. 8 years old, yep.
Crystal, I'm raising a litter of 5, which are 6 weeks old today. Is it too early to start basic obedience and bonk for nipping and jumping?
No.
I want them to have a good start before they leave my home.
No, what you do is 8 weeks old, correct? Yeah, at 8 weeks old, we're doing all
6 weeks old.
Oh, it's 6 weeks old? It's 6 weeks old. No, don't bonk right now, but you can do all. It's 6 weeks old. You can do all your marker and food training. You can start it. You might as well. If they're on kibble, they're probably doing moist kibble right now. They're probably off the tit. So what you can start, especially recalls. Next.
Dark Warrior. Hey, Jeff, I'm going to start helping some friends with their leash reactive Roddy. He pulled his owner down. I've been through the same shit with my own Roddy, so I know how scary it is.
Good for you. That's how I started, too. Good for you. Next.
Karen, GSD lover. Good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Enjoying the show.
Awesome. So are we. We have a great time.
Dark Warrior, I'm confident I can help them, though. Already got the e-collar. Let's fix this shit.
Damn right. Let's go, Dark Warrior.
Deb, all your at your seminars, is video or pictures of your own dog working on issues allowed? Just curious. Might be good for reference later on. I'm guessing probably not allowed, though.
No, we allow pictures. And put it this way, I do everything in front of everybody. We take videos of it. We put it up. The problem with people taking videos is... I don't want you getting bashed all over online. Just you showing up at my seminar, you're a dog abuser. That's how out of control it's
getting.
Somebody
said today that one of their best friends blocked them for wishing you a happy birthday.
I know. That's how fucked up people are.
Yeah.
It's like, you're so fucking close-minded. You know nothing about me other than some doctored video.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So it's like, it's so incredible. It's just so, so incredible. So the thing is like, no, I don't ban photography and video. I'm just like, use it responsibly. But things are taken out of context. Things are taken out of context. But I show everybody everything. If a dog lunges at me, I got to hold it up. I bonk dogs. I correct dogs high. I do, because it's the problem solving seminars. people bring their dogs to me for me to help them, and it's usually to correct them, and that's why they're there. Next.
Britt, do you think it's better to have loose leash when walking? I'm curious what you think.
Seriously?
I'm doing a lot of duration work, and she's doing great. My German Shepherd is doing good.
Of course. Of course, loose leash walking.
Or less leash. No, I think
she means less. Like the J. I'm sorry. No, not that we don't teach the J. Nothing against the J, but our clients, though, it's like they're not masters of leash handling. They're not masters of timing. They're not masters of dog training. I want a loose leash, but they don't need a ton of it. Now, that doesn't mean you can't teach it. If you want to take and remember, dog owners are my market here. So there's dog trainers that watch my show, but pet dog owners are my market. If you want to teach a classic, you know, AKC obedience class, go to one. But in the real world, though, there's too much room for error. Also, the dogs we work, man, that's the difference between a bite and not a bite. A dog fight and not a dog fight. Somebody knocked over and somebody not knocked over. Your dog getting hit by a car, not getting hit by a car. So to us, we love, watch how we walk. Dogs walk behind us. Dogs walk behind us. Next.
Jennifer, I just got a mini educator. So when I do all the training with working level, how do I know what level to go to when I eventually need to use it for discipline, not listening?
The dog will let you know. The dog controls the remote collar, not the human. You push the buttons, the dog controls the levels. When the dog cuts the shit and doesn't do it again, you've instilled an intolerable consequence into the dog. And they stop. Next.
Carrie, I gave my first dog lesson today, free. Use lots of techniques learned from you. Thank you. Dog is very fearful of me, though. How should I approach putting on the prong for the next week's collar dance?
Don't. Let the client do it. Or have a muzzle on the dog. Next.
Spuds. My same dog that I can call off rabbits and squirrels tried to take on a whole ass herd of deer. He trotted back after longer than acceptable to my standards, like nothing ever happened, but Lord, LOL.
So what I want you to do is this. Go to the exact same spot you did this at. Ready? Go to the exact same spot. All right? Have your remote on a high level. Let your dog off leash. As soon as your dog is 15 to 20 feet away from you, not in drive, call it back. Correct the dog. You won't fuck up the dog. The dog will be like, holy shit, that sucked. I better listen next time. So a lot of people will find this mean. Oh, you're going to destroy the recall. You're going to ruin the trust in the dog. Blah, 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 blah. It's like, first of all, have you ever done it? No. Well, then how do you know? You heard about it. Who'd you hear about it from? Did they ever do it? No. Okay, I do it, and it works. It works great. Why? Because 12 years ago, my dog turned on a dime. Uma was incredible at recall. I can call her off of anything, except for one day she went after a deer in drive and blew through the remote collar at the highest level, and this dog had recalled over 1,000 times to me and had great recall. That day, she didn't. So what did I do? I mean, she literally ran after the deer. So theoretically, I lost her. I mean, I found her, but I'm like, theoretically, she was gone. So what did I do after that? We went out the next day, same location, ran out, started looking around, probably for deer. Uma here. Boom. Didn't even give her a chance to turn around. Hit that button high. She came flying back to me. Ever since that day, never had a problem again. Next. This, by the way, guys, this is with a dog that knows recall. That's not how we train recall. Next.
Carrie, can I use a 3.0 on a small dog?
No, get a 2.25. 3.0 is overkill. Next.
Elise started training NCS recall today, and my dog's already nailing it. Can't wait to see where it takes us.
You awesome. Guys are the best. Awesome. Super proud of you. Next.
Gretzky, also, any tips on getting my GSD to not jump on my guest? She doesn't bite, but she's very energetic. Yep. At times, it's embarrassing. Love you guys for all the information.
Yes. The biting thing is bullshit. Okay. Anybody out there from the ER world, emergency room, first responders, nurses, doctors, most injuries from dogs are from being jumped on and knocked over and pulled over and dragged. They're more frequent and they're more expensive. Biting, schmiting. Dog bites, it sucks. Trust me. We don't want to have biting dogs. But being knocked over, it's unacceptable. How do you stop jumping? I have a video on how to stop jumping. It's a 1-second fix. Go to my YouTube channel, How to Stop Jumping. Next.
Bear, what is the best way to correct leash biting and play?
Leash biting and play?
Probably, huh? Like, acting like a fool.
Oh, okay. So, because usually when the dog's playing, it's off leash. So what your dog is doing is, you can bonk the dog, use a pet convincer with the dog, use the old school one, take one hand, pop it in the side like that if you want to. Next.
Did you already answer Levi's about being more valuable to your dog?
So being more valuable to your dog is pretty much holding your dog accountable for small things in the world, quick random pops, directional changes, don't letting your dog sniff randomly on walks. But a lot of it is just like holding your dog accountable for almost everything at the beginning. It's like the dog's like, man, I better pay attention to Levi because Levi doesn't let anything slide. It's not like this for the rest of the dog's life, but what it is your dog becomes more valuable to you. Everyone thinks, well, if you give it enough treats and enough love and affection, I'm like, no. If that worked, I'd fucking write a book on that. Okay?
Do you think we'd be doing it?
Okay. It's like, if that worked, why isn't every dog fucking incredibly well trained? Mm-hmm. But meanwhile, we clicker and food train dogs. But when it comes to a lot of stuff, there's a time, a place, a technique, a tool to apply a correction, a punisher, an aversion. Next.
All right, two parts. Crystal, yesterday for the first time, my dog stayed in heel. However, for the first time, she also pulled on the leash to sniff someone. The lady said, "Aw, good girl," and pet her. Now she's starting to do it whenever we pass people. I tell her no, but the person keeps petting my dog. I've been trying to avoid people, but it's hard.
Okay, person's petting your dog, that means you stopped. Unless they're walking next to you. Stop stopping. Walk. Walk with a mission. Nobody pets my dogs, and I don't have to tell them not to. I just look like the person. I don't have, like, resting bitch face. It's like, you know, it's like, I look like the person that doesn't want you to pet their dog. Walk with intent. Walk with intent. For some reason, who said that? Crystal? Mm-hmm. Crystal. Okay, be honest with yourself. You don't have to answer on this show, but be honest. How bad do you want people not to pet your dog? How bad? And what's your boundary issues? For some reason, you might not be able to say no. For some reason, you might get a little bit of satisfaction out of that. Walk with a goal. Next.
Jamie. If a dog comes in already knowing a command but worded differently, do you change the word or keep it the same?
Sorry. Man. I thought you were done. You paused.
Because there's a fucking question mark.
Okay. Okay. So.
What do you call that?
Punctuation.
Punctuation. I have to pause.
Thank you.
It's proper. Like saying bed instead of crate or all done instead of break. How do you change? We always change it.
We use the words we use or it's confusing for us. Next.
Levi, best drills for calmness, calm state of mind, like when you were just talking about the GSD earlier?
That was active training, but for calmness, it's duration. I've got 5 dogs right now all lying down doing nothing. Duration. Next.
Carrie said, my bad. The dog is a reactive, fearful little thing. I don't know what that's about.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Carrie. We're lost.
Daniel, is it good that my dog kind of gets excited, happy when I pull out the e-collar, which I use when we go on walks?
Yes. Next.
Lexi, my dog also has an issue with staring, loading on every dog, even if she never explodes now and looks at me after in between. Even with the correction, she always turns back to stare, no matter how many times.
You're not correcting your dog. You're tickling its balls. Okay? Correct your dog. Dial up. No. Correct. Next.
Chloe and Luca, I say Luca heel and he does, but then sometimes he breaks it 10 seconds to a minute later. Do I repeat the command or is it just no and correct? Do dogs remember commands like 2 minutes later?
Yeah, dogs can remember commands up to hours later. I don't know what level of training you've done with your dog, what stage of training you're done with your dog. Are you up to correction level yet? If you're not up to correction level yet, you wouldn't correct. You're still in the teaching level. So I don't know how far you've gone, but it's okay to say heel again. It's okay to say no again, but it all depends on what level you are, but absolutely. They're dogs, guys. They need reminders. Next.
Kindness matters. Just wanted to say I love the Year of Laughs video you recently put out. Your smiles make me happy.
Joelle, that video was fantastic.
And how to tailor really precise behavior. I want to train him to sit in a specific place and facing specific directions.
We don't do that.
Gets confused when I try to reshape or correct.
Right. Talk to a competition obedience trainer on that one. Next. Seriously, that's not the work we do. I'm a pet dog trainer. That's not my skill set. I can teach a dog to sit. I can teach a dog to sit for a long period of time. I can teach a dog to do a lot of things. I can teach a dog to stop unwanted behaviors. But what you're asking for is more formal and directional. And for that, you want to talk to somebody with a different skill set than myself. Next.
Jay, why are small dogs usually yappy and how can it be stopped?
Small dogs are usually yappy because they don't have deep barks. And then also they're yappy because a lot of owners find it cute and they don't stop it. Next.
Daniel, also last night I threw a bonker at my dog's crate since he was whining and scratching at the crate plastic flooring.
Good.
He growled at it, but then he stopped his whining. He's usually really good with the crate.
Good. Next time say no and then make sure you deploy. Excellent.
Katie, hey guys, I have participated in several training classes you did for the shelter in Greenville, South Carolina. Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, I heard they're switching things up down there. Heard there's a new director down there that definitely probably wouldn't let me on that property. Next. It's too bad because dogs were doing great.
Bear, he growls when he sees them on the street from a distance. I don't know what that's about either.
Dogs? No, and then a correction. So if your dog's growling at other dogs, no, and then a correction. That's how you stop things. Next.
Britt saying hello the other day. A lady asked if I took my German Shepherd to dog training lessons. I said, nope, just been listening to Solid Canine Channel, and she was so impressed how I handled my German Shepherd.
Awesome. Proud of you.
Nelza, oh my God, Jeff, my dog has his remote collar on. It shocks him, but he starts to bark even more and gets crazy. Help.
Okay, so number one, I don't know how you introduced it. I don't know how your training style is. I don't know your skill set. I don't know what you're trying to stop. I don't know what brand it is. A lot of variables there. Next.
Tommy, hi, J&J. My dog finally used to pet. He's too fearful and took 1.5 years. He's not the smartest. He's capped, but happy with the progress.
Good. Proud of you. Next.
Will, Akron cracks me up. Reminds me of that old FedEx commercial where they mispronounce Phoenix.
Really?
Everyone fucking rip what on they, Joelle.
Oh, shush. What,
it's fine.
What, shush. You rip on me every day of the year.
I have thick skin.
Every day of the year you rip on me.
No, I don't.
Oh, my gosh.
I don't rip on you.
If people saw the behind the scenes shit.
What, at work where I freaking don't even talk to you all day?
No. Wait, on the road?
I don't rip on you.
Oh, my
God. I rip on you on camera.
For just social media.
Exactly.
Content.
Did you see how I wished you happy birthday on my stories with your girl filter?
No, I didn't.
I called you a pretty girl.
Thank you.
On the airplane.
How do you mispronounce Phoenix?
I don't know. Phoenix?
Maybe. Maybe. Next.
I don't know. I'm the one who mispronounces everything, so I'll call it Phoenix. AJ said, dog training and autoerotic asphyxiation. It's always a good time.
It is. Hopefully not in the same room, though.
That would be weird.
That would be really weird.
Just use a dog leash.
That's right.
Nelza, I just want my 9-month dog to stop yapping when someone comes through the door. Thought the remote collar would help, but he barks even more.
So you might be underwhelming your dog. You might be underwhelming your dog.
Raven, Jeff ordered my prong collar from your Amazon list. New 6-foot leash, extra prongs, the convincer, and I'm so excited.
Awesome.
Damn.
Look at you.
I have a 10-month pit bull puppy. Overexcitement, focus, being a dick, watching your videos.
Good. Make yourself a bonker tonight. I've got videos on how to make a bonker, how to use a bonker. Bonk. Right after this show, I want you to bonk. Next.
Dark Warrior said dog training and masturbation tips. This show completes me.
Damn right it does. Huh? And on a Wednesday night. Hump day. Got it?
Look at that. I don't know too many dog trainers talked about this shit.
I don't know too many people that talk about this shit.
True that.
Next.
Lou, I just adopted a dog. I work full time. Do I kennel him during the day? He's been great so far.
The thing about it, I would say yes. I mean, but then it's like, oh, he's in the kennel for 8 hours. I'm like, to me, crating your dog is a safety issue. Dog could die by eating something outside the crate. Next.
Bear, is it too early to bonk a 13-week-old?
For what? For nipping at you? No. For barking? No. For whining? No. Next.
Katie, is a dominant dog collar able to be left on? I have a dog who's aggressive toward other dogs coming in our yard. He does have one friend he plays rough with. I worry the friend would catch the collar.
Ideally, when dogs play, they should be collarless because the bottom jaw can catch on any collar. Flat buckle collars. And what happens, it turns into a horrific dog fight. And usually the dog that's wearing the collar ends up dying because they end up getting choked. They end up getting choked out. Next.
Denzel, hey guys, my dog knows his commands, including heel, which I use, but it is nervous outside around people.
Yes.
His head is always moving, especially checking behind. He shakes when in a down stay by people.
Yeah, so your dog has got some fear issues. Work your dog through it. Get your dog to exist as many places as possible. The remote collar can override a lot of the fear issues and all that turning around. I would correct all that stuff. So start becoming more of a leader to your dog. But the shaking is the process. The shaking is part of the rehab process. Getting off of drugs, getting off of alcohol, stopping cigarettes, stopping coffee, you know, breaking any habit, there's going to be shaking. Shaking is working on your impulse control not to revert back to your old habits. So a lot of that is all part of the program. Next.
Karen, GSD lover. Dog is afraid of going up 4 steps to get into the house. I use prong and leash and let's go, but dog flies up all 4 still after the 10th time. Had to stop as he's falling when he reaches the top, injured himself.
Right. Okay, ready? Tight leash. Real slow. Let's go in a soft voice or heel. 1 step at a time. That dog tries to jump up, pop him back. 1 step. Stop. 2nd step. Stop. 3rd step. Stop. Top step, stop. 1 step at a time. Next.
I like how you broke it into 4 because there's 4 steps. Good right. job.
No problem at all.
I don't want to hurt you. Send you flying into a wall.
Said Joelle never.
Like, so never. You hurt me. Said Joelle never. I'm trying to give him like kudos. You hurt me.
Next.
So soft. Chloe and Luca, lift some freaking weight, would ya?
Next.
Luca doesn't listen without an e-collar or a prong. He knows all commands. We've been using both for 2 years. He's just an asshole. I'm so frustrated. Please help.
Okay. Number 1, consistency. Number 2, have you gotten up to correction level? Your dog should be under voice control, but it's not. So you've been possibly just reminding your dog all the time. Your dog is collar smart. You've never gotten your dog off of possibly prompt. And your corrections are meaningless, possibly. These are all possibilities. So what I would do is I would spend the next 90 days rocking your dog's world, getting that dog to listen. I don't know what your skill set is as a trainer, owner. Owners are trainers. I don't know what your skill set is. I don't know how you've been using the remote. If you're prompting every time and if you're reminding every time, tickling the balls, it's like, you know what? Your dog's always going to fucking need equipment. So let's get that dog to be accountable with your voice. And if not, there's a consequence. Next.
She-Wolf. Hi, J&J. Good evening.
Hello. How are you?
Hello. Landon, you don't have to read this out loud.
Read it out loud anyway.
The lavender croc thing wasn't an insult. I enjoy your content and results. Happy belated birthday, homie.
If it was an insult, you wouldn't be on the fucking show.
We would have blocked
you. Don't worry about it. Which is always weird when people are like, I went on his show and called him a fuck face.
And he blocked me.
Jeez, the guy doesn't like criticism. I called him a dog abuser and he blocked me. I was just trying to give him feedback. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to ask a question. So why do you feel you have, can't you train a dog without a remote collar, asshole? It's like, that's not a question.
Yeah.
You're being passive aggressive. Guys, I've been doing this for a long time. I know passive aggressive when I see it. So, next.
$4.99 top chat from the Noble Dog.
Oh, hey, Grant.
Started existential feeding with fearful dog that shakes when outside and won't eat. How many days should I try this before feeding the dog inside?
I don't know. This is it, Grant, man. This is the cool thing. The cool thing is this. You tell me. So, I would do this. Log it, do it, and get back to us. I don't know anything about the dog. I got no idea. Find out yourself. Keep doing it and see. You know, that's the thing. So, I mean, so many things I figured out starting in the first 8 years of my career. We figure out a lot of things at the training center by trial and error. Mm-hmm. We have a way of training almost every situation, but there's always going to be a dog that's like, damn, that just isn't working. Mm-hmm. We got to get creative. Mm-hmm. And guess what? As long as the safety of the dog is not put into jeopardy, we give it a shot. Mm-hmm. You know? Next.
Jamal. Oh my God, Jamal. What's up,
is that,
guys?
Is that the Jamal down in...
Yes.
Jamal that we know?
Like, literally, hello. Been a long time. Yeah, no shit.
Yeah, no shit. And I haven't changed my fucking phone number or my fucking show number or anything else, Jamal. Where you been?
He says, curious to know what app you use for captioning your videos.
Oh, you want some help, Jamal. That's it. So you're only coming back when you want some help. Okay? We do it ourselves, but you can use Splashio. Next.
Ourselves...
Joelle does it.
No.
Okay.
It's a lot of this.
Okay.
Thumbs. A lot of work.
Yeah. Manually.
Michelle, my mom came over today. My three dogs were in a sit stay in my dining room on the chairs. She was impressed, but also said it looked like the dog poker painting. Now I have to stage that.
Yes, definitely.
I have to add, though, it's not just me captioning. There's Maddie and Mackenzie.
And you have a team.
Yes.
I know. You have an awesome team.
We all caption and break our thumbs.
Yes, and we're looking for another intern. You know what we have to call? The woman, I'll tell you, she's got glasses in her bio.
Yep, I know.
Let's give her a shot.
Okay.
Let's give her a shot. Okay, we'll talk about that off the air. Next.
Baldurathustra. Hey, Jeff, I just bonked our five-month-old for carpet chewing. Worked immediately.
Yeah.
Plan on doing it for play biting and other issues.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Oh, my God, you did it for carpet chewing? Unless your fucking uncle owns a carpet store, damn right you do.
Yeah, and then you're going to get a freaking blockage, too.
I know.
Surgery.
Yeah.
Learn now, puppy.
People don't realize that carpet, like, you might have a carpet that's this shit, like this. I assure you, it's not a bunch of these small little fucking pieces of yarn.
No.
It could be a long fucking thing, gets wrapped around
right
the goddamn
in their intestines.
Next thing you know, fucking tightens them intestines off, forms a blockage. You got yourself a dead-ass fucking dog.
Dead. Surgery can't fix that
okay.
shit.
Okay.
Chloe and Luca. F-U to heal. He's in correction phase, I think, working on IPO. And don't yell at me for mentioning IPO. I know you're a pet dog trainer.
He's so well behaved,
only with the e-collar or prong on.
Why would I yell at you about mentioning IPO?
Is it no in correction since he's advanced?
Yes, but why would I yell at you for IPO? I don't yell at anybody, guys. I don't yell at anybody. This is just passion. And if I do yell at you, I'm busting your fucking balls. The only time I yelled was like last week's show with the thing with the kid with the hugging the dog. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I yelled that because that pisses me off because kids are innocent. But I'm not going to yell at you about IPO. Come on. Next.
Different worlds.
Yeah. But if your dog is an IPO dog, correct him.
All I know is once our dogs get to correction level, we don't keep saying heel. It's like, you're on a leash. You're next to me. We say heel when we leave. And if you forge, it's just correction. And
yeah.
They go right back. They know what the remote means.
Yes.
And they know the picture.
That's because... there's been lots of training prior to that.
Yes.
Right.
That's what
it
means. So our dogs that are on correctional, which
means
they're advanced.
Right. So if you've got an IPO dog that knows correctional, you can don't do your IPO training on in your pet dog world, but the a correction is a correction is a correction. Next.
Hey, J&J, we went to your Providence seminar. Lucy is killing it. Thank you, but recently, while practicing play, she will gnaw on her back nails. Not breaking skin, but it's disgusting. How can I stop it?
I'd fucking remove those nails. Just remove them. Pull them out. Tweezers. Pliers. Take a pair of fucking pliers, yank them fucking nails right out. What you can do is you can correct that. No, correct. It could be nervous. It could be boredom. It could be the beginning of an OCD thing. So I would just stop it, though. But, I mean, they do it. I mean, I saw Wes doing it the other day.
They both do it. It drives me nuts.
Yeah.
It's like, what are you doing?
They don't do it when you're not in the room.
No, they just do everything to drive me nuts.
Pretty
Bert
much.
Bert will put his whole foot in his mouth and just like look at me, like with his foot in his mouth.
Yeah.
Like,
it's so funny.
What are you doing?
It's so funny because I hang out with Joelle's dogs all day long, and I'm like, they're so well behaved, they're so rested, they're so peaceful, they're like so quiet. She walks in the room, and immediately she's fucking yelling at these dogs, and I'm like, huh. Anything like that went on with them.
He wakes up from a dead sleep. I see it every time. I'll come in. I try not to look at him. I'll get my coffee. He's like, like fucking Zoolander, staring at me.
That's a good comparison.
He starts panting. I'm like.
I know. I never see that. I don't see that behavior.
Never. It's so weird. Katie, 11-week puppy biting older dog's neck. Sometimes older dog doesn't mind and ignores or gently mouths the pup.
Yeah.
Other times the older dog does not like it, has growled and corrected pup, but good. Pup doesn't back off.
Ooh, okay. So you've got to give that dog a bonk. Yeah. Well, I'm glad your older dog is... It sounds like your older dog is being a very fair puppy raiser. But... Okay, two ways to play this. Let it keep happening, and let's see if that older dog steps up its correction, because obviously it's being fair. Let's see if it steps it up to be like, hey, you little fucking young shit, I told you to back off. You didn't listen? I'm going to up my correction. Maybe you'll listen to that. I'd see if that plays out. So it sounds like your older dog does have the skill set, but the younger dog isn't getting the message. Let's see if your older dog starts upping the consequence. Let's just see if that happens. Next.
Michelle, I miss erotic asphyxiation. I hate when I'm late for the stream. Where you been, Michelle? You missed it.
Yep, you got it. She was doing her own stream. Yep, next.
What?
It was an orgasm joke. Next.
Ew. Bear, what age do you start e-collar training?
You can start getting them conditioned to it at age 14 weeks old. Teaching them pressure on, pressure off. Next.
Nelza, hey, can you explain what underwhelming your dog means?
Yeah, underwhelming your dog means think about it this way. You're trying to stop an unwanted behavior. And your dog it's on a remote collar. And you say no, and you hit the button at a certain level. But your dog doesn't stop the behavior. Or it stops it for a second and then goes back to it. Then you hit the button again. The dog stops for a second and goes back to it. What you're doing is you're tickling its balls. You're underwhelming its behavior. I mean, you're underwhelming the dog. Instead, dial up, say no, make it mean something. Your dog goes, holy shit, that sucked, and stops the behavior. Most people are underwhelming their dogs, and I understand why. So usually, most people just need to dial up. Next.
Tommy, thank you for the free videos and shows. Bonker, save me. You guys are always inspiration to me. Open my eyes.
Awesome.
Nelza. And I basically put the bark collar on him. I did vibration. That didn't work. Now I do shock. Basically, the collar is on low. The more he barks, the more it increases, and then has a two-minute safety
mode. Yeah, stop doing automatic. Okay. So stop. So number one, stop using vibrate, which you've done. Stop using automatic. Find the right level that actually shuts the dog up, 1 through 6, whatever brand it is, and that's the level. So they might give a little bit of a yip, but they stop barking. Next.
Kibu, hi Jeff and Joelle. The other night when Kibu reacted to the other GSD and I corrected several times with no and popped before he finally stopped. You suggest a Skype. What did I do wrong?
I don't know what you did wrong. I wasn't there. I don't know what your timing is. I always suggest a Skype for people that are struggling because there might be a lot of other components. Plus, we can have a one-on-one conversation. It's a huge difference. Next.
Jamie, do you work with small dogs very often? It makes sense that we mostly see you work with medium to large dogs because of their strength, but I was just wondering.
No. Dog training is dog training. It's not a strength thing.
We just got a small dog in today.
Guys, it's not a strength thing. No. We work with little dogs, but we also don't, like, we don't advertise we work with small dogs. We don't advertise we work with big dogs. We say we work with any dog. And a lot of people with small dogs, though, aren't training them. So we don't get that market. Next.
Hey, we had little Rocky, a little 14-week-old Havanese.
But you have to understand, we absolutely get medium to large dogs in here.
Oh, definitely.
So it's like...
Mostly pit bulls and German shepherds.
Yeah, too. But it's not like we specialize in that. No. But it's like...
It's just like...
That's what we get. That's what we get. Next.
We got a little Jack Russell mix today.
Yep.
Which is going to be fun. Kibu, already read that. Jamie, read that. Dark Warrior, my Roddy growled at a lady yesterday who wanted to sell us prescription drugs. For once, I didn't mind his reactivity.
What drugs were they, though? Oxys? Viagra?
How do you just sell somebody prescription drugs?
You go to the pharmacy, you get your drugs, and you fucking sell them on the black market.
Oh.
Because
it's sheltered. People just walk up to you like, hey, you want some drugs?
Do you remember the time I was in, where was I? I was at the Walmart, and I walked out. I think it was Florida. And I walked out of the Walmart. This might have been when I was...
Was I with you?
No. I was down there closing on one of the houses. I walked out of a Walmart, and to my right was a middle-aged older couple. And the woman a little bit larger, had a shmata on, you know, like a night shirt on.
Shmata?
Shmata, fucking rag.
A muumuu.
And I'm walking towards my car, and she catches up to me, and she's like, can you give me $5 for 5 minutes of your time? And I'm like, number one.
What would I be?
I'm number one. Are we talking about a 5 minute blowjob? Are we talking about like you to share your sob story with me? Like,
why would you pay her?
It's like, if you want $5, just ask me for $5. Like, I'm not working on the barter system with you.
Yeah.
It doesn't work that way with me. So it's like, but that freaked me out a lot. I'm like, no, thank you. Meanwhile, I give people money all the time.
Yeah.
But it's like, the way you address that.
I can just see you being like super weird too.
The way you address that, like, and it's not because you had the shmata on. It's like, that I don't negotiate. I'm not negotiating like that.
Shmata.
Ducks.
I learned like so many weird words from you. Shmata.
It's Yiddish.
It's a muumuu.
It's called, but you call it a muumuu. I call it a shmata.
$4.99 top chat from the Noble Dogs. How long is too long and not safe? I'm 5 days and worried that it may be going long, too long, but also don't want to be soft.
Do you mean the dog hasn't eaten yet?
Yeah.
I put, they make some stuff you can put in their water to add nutrients, but we're not interested in doing that. We'll feed the dog. We'll feed the dog.
Just train next. Without food.
Yeah, just train without food. Just use pressure. Next.
Jenny, no questions today. Just stopping by to say hey. I was the one that shared the Wolfie on Insta.
Oh, nice. Awesome.
Nelza said the bark collar is called Capkit dog bark collar, anti-bark collar.
Never heard of it. We like Garmin Pet Bark Limiter and the e-collar technologies. It has the I think it's called the ultra-sensitive bark collar. Next.
Adventure McLoy in the Navy. Fuckface is a term of endearment, LOL.
Well, we ain't in the fucking, we're not in the fucking Navy here.
See?
So when she calls me fuckface, she's insulting me.
I don't think I've ever called you fuckface. Come on.
No, you haven't.
I don't call you anything mean.
No, you don't. You're very kind to me. And I'm being serious. Yes.
I think so.
I think so, too.
Cynthia. Hi, J&J. My dog runs from me when he sees me coming with the e-collar. I need your advice.
So keep a leash on the dog. Present the e-collar. Do a ton of food training with it. So what we do is we layer the remote collar on low levels with the existing food training we've been doing. And it's usually a fun thing. But just keep a leash on the dog. Next.
Katie, thanks. I asked about the dominant dog collar. Do you have any other suggestions for being possessive of the yard? Right now, we have hoses as many places as possible.
Why?
With a large yard, there are some holes. Gagging him with a hose is the most useful tactic to get him off a dog. Would a remote collar work and drive?
Get him off a dog? What's he doing?
He's attacking dogs in the yard.
Whose dogs are going in your yard?
Random dogs, it sounds like.
Your dog shouldn't be off leash then. Like, what, why aren't you can't, what, who's, how many dogs are coming in this person's yard?
I don't know.
So, you got hoses everywhere? Jesus Christ.
My God.
You've got to, hopefully your lawn looks nice. You got a lot of gardening going on. What I would do is a remote collar could, it's a yes or no. It's a 50-50 chance. It might increase the bite or decrease the bite next.
Oh my God, my hamstrings are still so sore.
Next.
I'm trying to readjust myself. Kendrim. Does neutering a dog calm a dog? Does it make him less reactive? My dog forgot all commands once there's another dog in the park.
We've never seen that. Now, I'm not saying it hasn't happened. Every dog that comes in here has been de-sexed, and guess what? They've got all kinds of problems. Next.
Chloe and Luca, by tickling his balls, do you mean by my corrections aren't harsh enough?
Correct. LOL. Correct. That's what I meant by tickling the balls. It was not. It's not a term of endearment. Next.
Chloe and Luca said his non-existent balls.
Right.
Raymond, I just want to say thanks again for all the help, J&J.
You're welcome, Raymond.
Chloe and Luca, Joelle, F.U. is follow-up. Oh, not actually F.U. Oh, I read it as F.U. Like the dog saying F.U. to heal.
Right.
Thomas, tons of chemicals and toxins in the carpet, too.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah, there's like formaldehyde in
there. I was just going to say formaldehyde.
Lou, thank you for doing this. I found you today and binge-watched many videos at work. At work?
Uh-oh.
Where do I start with my new shelter dog? You make so much sense, and I feel like we'll be successful with your help.
Start at we're redoing all of our, we're literally doing a whole new series of 2020 on how to be successful with your dog. It's going to be, we've started to do it. We've only gotten one out so far, but we're literally just started doing it this week. We've got two more coming out tomorrow or the next day. But right now, go to the do it yourself playlist right now. And then also just start the work. Who's that?
That is Lou.
Lou, start with crate training, thresholds, place command, cut down on affection, lots of structure. Start there. Next.
Bear, what does IPO stand for? New to this.
You know what? IPO, it's a sport. They replaced Schutzhund with IPO. It's a working dog sport. It does courage. It does, I don't actually even know what all the things that it does, so I shouldn't even be talking about it. So look it up. Google IPO. Next.
Nelza, I love these lives. Honestly, I'm able to ask the questions that I need help with.
Good. Yes. IPO is not my thing. Schutzhund was more of a, they do bite, track.
Courage. It's mostly like it tests like temperament to be able to breed. You have to be titled.
Right. But that doesn't exist anymore, at least in the States. And in Europe now, it's not existing that much anymore. And actually, in the next 10 years, IPO won't exist.
It's scary for breeding. Be breeding some.
Yeah. In 10 years, dogs. Almost all dog sports will be non-existent in the United States.
Yeah. I believe it.
In Europe, definitely. In the United States, absolutely.
Can't say no anymore.
Yep.
9 to 5 beauty boss. Hey there. What do I do about my 2-year-old dog randomly peeing in the crate at night, although he's been taken out before bed? He has no UTI.
Shrink the crate. Monitor the water. You can also, people always do shrink the crate, you know, width-wise. You can shrink the crate height-wise, not forever, so the dog can't stand up. Next.
Oscar, in my opinion, I feel as if my GSD is pretty well-trained, but I can't figure out how to get him more comfortable with new people. I can tell he wants to meet them, but once he starts to smell them, he gets cautious.
Yeah, so I think this is, you might have just a little bit of a nervous, fearful dog. So this is the thing. I'm a big advocate of existence, a huge advocate of existence. So I'm not a big fan of my dogs just walking up to random people, but my dogs can walk up to random people. They're very social. I'm a big fan of my dog being around lots of different situations, but not necessarily interacting in those situations. I want my dogs to sort of ignore stuff. Next.
Let's see. Lori.
IPO equals tracking, protection, obedience. There you go.
There you go. Lori, my dog is digging up the whole backyard.
Remote collar, make it suck to dig a hole. Next.
Delana, hey J&J, how can I walk guide a strong puller with a slip lead that hangs low on the dog's neck? I just started dog grooming school and they only provide slip regular leashes.
Good luck. Good fucking luck. What you do is this. Whoever provided that slip lead, hand them the slip lead and say, show me how to walk this dog. And if they can't do it, if the instructor can't do it, why do they expect the student to do it? Literally say, show me how to do this. And then whatever they do, if they're successful, duplicate it. But if they won't do it, and if they can't show you how to do it, say, why are you making us do it if you can't even do it? Allow us to use fucking tools that actually work, like a prong collar. Low on the dog's neck, do you mean the most powerful part of the dog so it can pull?
Yeah, no. If you're going to use a slip, it should be higher.
If you're going to use a slip, at least use it super, super fucking high. But even then, that takes a skill set. You probably got to do some footwork with that, some heel taps, directional changes, or put a damn prong collar on the dog, do the prong collar dance, and boom, you got a dog walking next to you. But they won't do that. Why? Ideology. Next.
Amanda, Jeff, out of curiosity, what made you want to own GSDs and a Malinois? I love watching you guys a few times a week.
For some reason, 15 years ago, I got my first GSD. I liked it. Malinois, I swore up and down I would never get one. Unfortunately, one of our clients, dear person who is struggling, obviously, with some issues, committed suicide and left the dog to us. Didn't leave it here. But he wanted the dog to come up to us. Wonderful, wonderful man who was obviously struggling. You know, a lot of people out there are struggling right now. He took his own life, and then Tex was, I guess, technically willed to us in the note, and we took him. And every once in a while, I'll yell at him. I'm like, stop being a fucking Malinois. So every once in a while, I'll yell at him for being a Malinois. But he's a really good dog. He runs with my pack. He's safe with my kids. He's safe with other dogs. So That's why. I mean, that's why. Next.
Bear, what e-collar do you recommend for a Great Dane who'll be 14 weeks next week? Do you have to get a bigger one as he gets older, or just get a
No. You can get the e-collar technology 300. That'll be good. Next.
Chloe and Luca, is there an e-collar that has a remote on an Apple Watch or phone? If not, we should create it. That would be okay. Really cool.
So the technology is already exists that there are. Like the sex industry.
It's okay. Like, Siri, correct my dog.
The sex industry has sex toys that run through Wi-Fi. Okay? If this makes you uncomfortable, tough shit, get over it, fucking get off the show. So the thing is this, the technology exists. We need to come up at a minimum with a remote collar that can, if you're the dog's at home and the remote collar can pick up a Wi-Fi signal. And your phone can either be on data or Wi-Fi, which it usually is. You can literally have a conversation with your dog. Not like, hi, how are you? But literally correct your dog from your phone. So if anybody out there is thinks that they can do that, or do it. Do it. You want to talk about a fortune to be made? There is a fortune to be made.
Let's invent it.
Hundreds of millions of dollars. Because this would save so many dogs' lives. Next.
Me, you, and John, our coding guy.
Get John, our coding guy. John, contact me about this. Let's go.
Patent this shit. Sean, 9-month GSD puppy, finally better around other dogs and doesn't fear stage bark as much. Was told neutering is best for GSDs and behavior once it's a year.
That's bullshit. That's the stupidest fucking advice. I believe spay and neuter is a personal choice, just like for females. But this is the thing, man. I, who work with lots of dogs, our company works with lots of dogs. I travel the world working with lots of dogs. I'm not seeing de-sexing the dog change behavior. Has it happened? Does it happen? I'm sure it does. I'm sure it does. But for some weird reason, every dog that comes in here has been de-sexed. Every dog that gets put down for bad behavior historically has been de-sexed. It all boils down to training. Next.
Ro, your videos are great. Thanks for all the amazing free content.
You're welcome. I thought I didn't know if that was a pause or you're done.
You're welcome.
I was waiting for you to...
I'm Jeff Gellman, and I'm serious tonight. Welcome to the podcast. Can we do a serious show one night? I don't think I could even.
I don't think I could.
So you're going to want to put the 225 prong collar on your dog's neck.
Next.
That's funny. Yes. Steph says hello.
Hey, Steph. How are you?
Baldura Thustra. Hi, Jeff. Our Borobel puppy tends to walk fine outside of our fenced-in yard, but when we try to do any leash training inside the fenced yard, he is constantly biting the leash, jumping up and down.
Yes. So your dog, it's just all situational. Your dog is, your dog, okay, I'll make it really easy for you. Your dog's playing you. He's playing you. He thinks it's a game. He thinks, now in the comfort of my own home, I play a game. So what do? Get yourself a bonker. No bonk. To tell your dog to cut the shit. Literally, your dog is playing you. It's playing you. Next.
Ro, what's the best place to order a prong collar?
From our website, solidcaninetraining.com. It's like, let me make $3 profit. Next.
Katie, about my pup biting the older dog. Pup isn't mine. Don't know if I trust my dog not to overdo the correction.
Yeah, I mean...
Pup with me for 6 months. What are the other options? I don't want dog to overdo the correction.
You can just correct a dog with a bonker. No, correct. Next.
Deb, I know that breed doesn't really matter, but curious if you work with many Bensajis.
Bensajis.
Yes. I have dyslexia. I've had dogs all my life, and this is the strangest breed I've owned. I love the quirkiness. It's so stubborn.
You don't have to worry about them barking too much historically.
They like sing.
I have worked with probably less than 12 Bensajis in 15 years. But... stubbornness is lack of motivation. You need to find the motivator. If it's not food, if it's not a toy, if it's not verbal praise, which a lot of times it's not, it's going to have to be compulsion. What's compulsion? Old school. And there's a way to do it. So somebody makes a comment about old school making their dog fearful, but that's because too much emotion was put into it. There's a time and a place for a good firm leash pop. There's a time and a place for that. But when you follow it up with yelling and screaming and anger, that's how you fuck up your dog. But the act of giving it a leash pop, the act of giving it a correction with a smile on your face, not because you're happy you're correcting the dog, that's not going to mess up the dog. Next. But a remote collar would dramatically help. We remote collar train all dogs, including Basenjis. Next.
Wait, did you just read the next comment?
No.
Are you sure?
I'm not even looking at the same screen as you.
All right, because Jamie says, my dad is a farmer and trains dogs the old-fashioned way.
Oh, I saw that comment earlier. Oh,
okay. Yes. Exerting dominance over normal dogs, yelling, hitting.
Yes.
Because of this, he is fearful and shy border collie.
Right.
And an aggressive red heeler.
Yes.
That has bitten him 3 times and attacks the other dog. No amount of hitting or yelling has ever stopped this, but the second I get a prong and e-collar, I'm the abusive one.
Right, right. So you really want to take emotion out of it. So I'm not an advocate for yelling. I'm definitely not an advocate for yelling and hitting. We all yell at our dogs at some point. I mean, let's all be honest with ourselves. But when you use emotion and you're using frustration and you're being angry, it's a good way to sort of F up your dog. But there is something to be said. A lot of old school farmers, all your ranch dogs, as long as you're fair with your dog, you're fair with your corrections, you'll be okay. But it sounds like your dad might not have been fair. He might not have been fair. You know, who knows? Or he also might have had just dogs that were going to be end up that way anyway. I don't know. We'll never know. We'll never know. Next.
Diane said DIY on YouTube.
Yeah, do it yourself. Yeah, there's just a playlist. Next.
Invictus Media just discovered your channel. Thanks for all the great info.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for being a fan. We're getting new fans every day. We're getting more and more fans now.
Yeah. $5 top chat from Eric.
Hey, Eric.
My 7-month-old bully tries to sit, lay on top of the other three. I think it's a dominant thing, but she shows no aggression. I correct, but she tries constantly.
Maybe she's just comfortable, you know? So, I mean, I've seen dogs literally just do like little pile-ups, you know what I mean? So, she's only 7 months old now. At 9 months old, you might start seeing, historically at 9 months old, we see some, at sexual maturity, we see some aggression come out in dogs. So, to me, you know, do the other dogs mind? I mean, is the dog literally just trying to make itself comfortable? Is the dog insecure and it's using the other dogs for comfort? Is the dog just used to, like, I've seen dogs just do pile-ups. You know, there's a lot of variables there. If I had a 7-month-old dog that was showing no aggression at all and was doing fairly well and was on the right curve of obedience training, and the other three dogs, it wasn't stressing them out, and I might just be like, you know what? Let me just pick my battles. Next.
Christine, hi, Jeff and Joelle. Need advice on a nipping 8-month-old French bulldog.
Okay, no and bonk. Literally, say no and bonk. It'll stop. You can do it to a Frenchie. Okay, next.
Nelza, so Jeff, you recommend returning my automatic collar and get one with the controller for best results?
No, your automatic collar, your automatic collar, that's the A function. It should have a 1 through whatever number function.
1 through 6.
1 through 6 function. You probably can make your automatic collar manual. You should be able to. I don't know what brand it is. But there's usually have that option though. Next.
Like, instead of it going up level by level, each bark, just keep it on one level.
Keep it on the right level. How do you find the right level? Trial and error by just, like, knocking on the door.
But the automatic level escalates dogs. Then they bark, get corrected, bark, get corrected.
Right,
get corrected.
Right. And I know sometimes they'll have a lag time. Not a lag time. It will stop as, like, a safety. But you're better off getting the right level. Because then it's like the frog in the water. It doesn't know that it's boiling.
And then they freak out.
Yep.
Chloe and Luca, you would mention sex toys when comparing to e-collars, LOL.
Well, I used to be in the sex industry, and keep in mind, guys, people love to use the sex industry against me. It's like, let's turn it to, oh yeah, he used to sell dildos. It's like, no, I built a $3.5 million company from zero. It's like, stop chastising me and actually learn something. You know what I mean? So all I know is this, it's like, thank God for the sex industry because we can do FaceTime now. We can video chat. I mean, the sex industry drives drives a lot of stuff. Now, obviously, I don't agree with sex trafficking. I'm talking about sex toys. And I'm not going to get into the whole pornography thing, and I'm not going to get into any of that right now. All I'm saying is, from a technological standpoint, from a manufacturing standpoint, from a lot of different standpoints, what I'm going to say is, it's driven a lot of technology further, faster, because it's so profitable, like the internet, like bandwidth, like video stuff. Next.
Steph, can you talk in depth about dogs becoming collar smart? We train for retriever events using e-collars, but because we are training at a distance, very quickly they become collar smart, knowing when the collar is off during our tests.
So during your test, so I'm not familiar with hunt and field trial work, but I've seen it done, and it's impressive as fuck. During the test, though, you're allowed to have the collar on, yes or no? Are you just relying on the whistle and visual cues?
They're probably not allowed to during a test.
Oh. So then what you have to do is you've got to practice without the collar then. And I would talk to your collar smart means the dog only listens when the collar's on. But if you're doing the skill set you have is a different skill set than mine. Your trainer, whoever is training your hunt dog, I would talk to them about how to get past all that. They absolutely must know, because I don't compete dogs. So they probably train on the remote. A lot of them are running Tritronic collars mostly. They used to be Tritronic collars. Now they're Garmin collars, because Garmin bought Tritronic. So a lot of them are running those collars. And I'm sure this is a frequent problem they have when they actually have to do testing. So I would talk to one of your hunt trainers or go into a hunt forum. You know, most hunt trainers are like, they don't know that people don't like remote collars. I remember when I was out in Texas, I was doing a seminar at a hunt and field trial place, and the trainer there, the resident trainer there, that's what he does. Mm-hmm. He just does hunt and field trial dogs. He did it, his father did it, his grandfather did it. And he's like, people don't like remote collars. He was oblivious. He's like, I had no idea. They just don't know. It's like, of course we use remote collars.
Yeah. They're probably not on social media either.
Yeah, or they are, but they just don't. That's not their world. That's not their world, you know? So, next.
Chloe and Luca said, let's patent it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
First, you got to invent it. Then you got to patent it. Next.
John. Come on, John.
Next.
Carrie, this is like the freaking love, brother love, travel and salvation show. Neil Diamond, Joel. You guys rock, and I was a critic. Now a huge fan. Love your heart, man. Stay solid.
Who said that?
That is Carrie.
So, Carrie.
Carrie Kofsky.
Welcome over.
John is on the show.
John.
John! We need your help.
Okay, John, don't answer. Well, you better answer John's question. Guys, hold on. Answer John's question before it disappears.
$4.99 top chat from John. Hi, guys. Dog has desire to sprint into his crate every time after a potty break. End of leash and prong stop him, but he continues to want to do it. How to stop?
Number one, close the crate door. Teach the dog. Is that our John?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, did the meetup?
Boating John, yeah.
Oh, my God. So, stop the dog. Close the dog's crate and teach the dog to pause and kennel up. And then open the crate, teach the dog to come out on command, go in on command. Also, John, we just made a video about you. And in there, John, one of the commenters was a woman who has a 13-year-old son, mm-hmm, that likes coding. Please reach out to her. Please reach out to her. Okay? John, you have inspired a lot of people, buddy. Okay? You've inspired a lot of people. You have value, okay? You have value, not just to the marketplace, but to other humans. I want you to know that, all right? I appreciate you. Also, what kind of coding do you do, and can you make remote collars work on Wi-Fi so I can control a remote collar from my cell phone? Do you know anybody that can do that? Now,
Back to Carrie. Who was a critic and now likes us.
This is it. So, Carrie, first of all, you can send me the official apology letter at jeff@solidcaninetraining.com, okay? I actually get those.
Do you?
Oh, yeah. I get them if I haven't blocked them. But usually I don't block them by email.
True.
People ask me if I can unblock them on social media all the time.
It's like, we got like 20,000 people on that list. Yeah, we can't find you.
It's like, It's like people I have blocked for, you know, so many things, mostly passive aggressive stuff or just outright blatant hate. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people, though, started out hating me and have said, I guess this guy makes sense. You know, and some people don't like me just because of my personality. Some people don't like me because they only see one side of me, which is the correction side. They don't see what we actually do. So welcome to the club, Carrie. I'm glad you're back. But even when you hated me, this is the thing, Carrie. Even when you hated me, I still loved you. I still loved you. I still cared about you. If anything, I probably had empathy for you. And that's fine. And that's fine. And it's your right to not like me. That's the great thing about this is like, it's your right not to like somebody. But I think more people need to be like...
They're still here. So it means he or she did not go out of their way to write us hate, at least.
Right.
Hey, because you would have been banned. So that's cool.
Right. Right. That's you're just a silent, you're a silent hater.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next.
Steph, very quickly. Oh, I read that already. 73 Blue Note. Hey, Jeff, I went to show someone your bike bonk video and found out it was marked private. I'm sorry you're getting so much heat. I hope you'll make it public again at some point or even for a limited time.
So that the bonking videos have been made private, not necessarily by us. That's all I can say. Okay? That's all I can say. So there's some things going on in the background that are not are getting me in trouble at all, but other people in trouble. So right now they're private. Right now they're private. Next.
Christine, good to know about the shaking. New structure. One was shaking tonight.
Next.
Michelle, yeah, it's pretty fun to have a stranger across the world control your vibrator in real time.
Yes.
As for Wi-Fi e-caller, I would just worry about Bluetooth lag and timing of corrections.
Correct. But I've thought about that too, but also, who just said that?
Michelle.
So I've thought about that too. And you know what's in no difference in that is nanny cams that have lag time. So a lot of times you'll have a nanny cam on your dog or a remote camera on your dog and there's lag time on that. Or if I'm Skyping with a client, there might be a little bit of lag time. But if your dog is trained on the remote, you can allow for a little bit of lag time. And mostly you're on correction level anyway. So we're not training, we're correcting. Next.
Chloe and Luca, why does my GSD only nap when I'm sitting or sleeping? Is this a GSD thing? It doesn't bother me, but sometimes I'm like, dude, don't you want to just sleep? I wish I could be a dog and sleep whenever.
Teach your dog how to do nothing. Teach your dog how to do nothing.
Wes does nothing and stares at me like this. Like, he's in his crate, like, he's sleeping right now.
Yeah, I know.
But if I come in during the workday.
I know.
He's like.
I know, I see it.
Like.
And you yell at him and I'm like. It was fucking peaceful in here until you walked in. So
I can't even be in here.
I'm in here all day getting work done.
Yep.
And all of a sudden, you walk in. Your
not
dog.
Not even in the room. I walk in the front door.
I know. Your dog whines and you yell. It's like between the two of you.
Sopranos.
It's between the two of you. It's like, one of you better shut up. And I got a feeling you'll shut up first.
I just leave the room.
Thank you.
It's the ultimate punishment for him.
Yep.
Raven, my pit does the same thing, sitting butt thing.
Next.
Swift Bird, I have a younger dog, 1 year old, that is a miniature Australian Shepherd that gets upset and bites the face of my very old full-sized Aussie. I got to replace him. What should I do?
One more time?
I don't know. I have a younger dog that is a miniature Australian Shepherd that gets upset and bites the face of my very old Australian Shepherd.
Okay, it doesn't get upset. So let's reword that. Your dog's a dick and bites the face of your older dog. You need to say no and tell him to knock it off. But on the flip side, is it really a bite or is it play? Next.
Michelle P. said my pits do that too, stackable dogs.
Yeah, yeah.
Martin, my dog tries to run out the door to the street whenever I open it. Any advice? E-collar maybe?
Barrier training. Do barrier training. Next.
D. Hardy, Happy New Year, Jeff. My husky is mouthy to me when I go into my daughter's room or hug her. She seems protective.
Oh, number one, that husky, get that husky out of that room tonight. Crank that dog up at night and teach that dog the out command, meaning get the fuck out of here. Next.
Raven, at 9 months, my pit Jasper suddenly started growling at other dogs.
Yep.
Fur up, wanting to lunge.
Yep, yep.
I think it's overexcitement, not aggression, making my bonkers as we speak.
Yeah, well, we see a lot of aggression come out at 9 months at sexual maturity. Next.
Kibu, When we got Kibu from the breeder, we signed an agreement to neuter him when old enough, as he is pet quality. The breeder is selected for breeding.
Okay. Then I guess you got to, you that's a decision you need to make. Mm-hmm. Next.
Jamie, thoughts on decompression walks? Some people say dogs need to have walks with no expectations and also have structured walks. But should you always have them in a heel when walking?
Except, well, I mean, my dogs are off leash, so they're off leash a lot playing. But if you live in New York City or any big city where your dog always has to be on a leash, your dogs are usually always in a heel, you know? But that's up to you. This concept of a decompression walk, that's a fancy fucking term for not heeling your dog, if you ask me. Next. That's almost like an acronym, you know? BAT, you know? Next. BAT means lots of time and lots of money and no results. Next.
Chloe and Luca, you don't have to defend yourself about your sex toy industry, Jeff. It's cool. Someone's got to do it.
Oh, I don't defend myself at all. I'm super proud of my sex toy industry. I'm extremely proud of it. I went over to Europe without knowing anybody and worked deals to bring silicone sex toys in the United States as an exclusive distributor. I mean, I'm very proud of my work. I'm very proud of how I built that company up from zero. Next.
Steph said, no collar or leash. I'm the trainer. LOL, we all have the same problem, even the pros.
Really? Fuck. Well, they're dogs. They make mistakes. I wonder if those dogs, I mean, there is a theory. Who's that, Steph? Steph, I know in a lot of the worlds, but see, you guys correct your dogs on the remotes during training, though. So I'm wondering if you can do a whistle cue, which means no, which is followed up with a correction. The temperament of the dogs that you're running should be able to handle a correction. No, it's going to get a correction and cut the shit. But that's not my world. That's not my world. I'm amazed by that world. I'm amazed at you guys doing, a double whistle blow to turn your dog around and hold position, and then you can do directionals, blind finds, and I'm amazed by that world. All the water work that you do, amazed by it. You got a dog out there, you send a dog out in the water, blow the whistle twice, it turns around, stays in the position, send it to the left, send it to the right, blow the whistle again, it turns around, tell them to go a different way. I'm amazed by that work. I'm amazed. So, Steph, I can't really answer your question because I don't work dogs. My dogs listen to me off equipment, but they're not doing complicated tasks. But how do you do that? Lots of repetition. Get the dog up to a punishment level, get it under voice control, put a cue to it, which is going to be your whistle, I imagine, and just repeat. Next.
It's already 9:30.
Is it really? Oh, shit.
We still have not even made it through.
All right. Well, time to go.
Fraction of these, yeah.
All right. Time to go.
Yep.
All right. We got to go. So next show is Saturday night. Tomorrow night, we got dinner out with
a lighting guy.
A lighting and sound guy.
Some professional lights in here.
To improve our, we want to build a professional podcast
booth. So I can look tan all the time? Can we get like a
filter?
A tanning light?
I wonder if we can get a filter put on. Just put a filter. We can get a tanning light. That, and we're taking our shadow student. We have a shadow student that came over from Singapore. Tang came over from Singapore. And we're taking him out to dinner. And then Friday night, we got something going on Friday night.
Frank, a client.
Oh, we got to go to a client's house. That's right. All right, guys. Madly in love with you. Sorry we didn't get to all your questions. That's just the way it is. Joel goes on these rants. All right?
Yeah.
All right. Madly in love with you. Take care, guys.
Good night.
Bye-bye.